going with some of their old things that they do, such as Pileidae Bounty Hunter. Mm-hmm. Very good at scouting the opponents out and avoiding fights when needed. And they may need to do that in the early game to let their Ember and their Doom get some farm.
All right, so as our players are finally going to be picking their heroes, we'll head on into the game. But Team Secret adopting the Shadow Shaman now, getting themselves some pushing power, but the last pick, Lycan. Vici Gaming getting some serious pushing power of their own are actually now able to end the game quick, perhaps before the Ember Spirit and Doom really hit their mid to late game stride.
Yeah, and it's a decent hero for what Secret has as well. It's a lot of physical damage and it's at high mobility, which are things that potentially could allow them to kill things like Doom. If you can crit and get some damage in and you can lock them down with somebody like Spiritbreaker, then Doom could actually just die at the start. Ember Spirit as well, very weak to physical damage at most stages of the game due to his low agility gain and his very low agility item purchases. So I think the Lycan could work out interestingly. I also saw there was an, I don't remember what game it was, but I also saw a fifth pick ban on Lycan as well. So I think it's a pick that has been occasionally used within the Chinese.
Yeah, there was a Chinese matchup. I'm not sure if it was like LGD versus Ehome, or perhaps it was a VG Gaming where they did pick up the Lycan specifically against the Doom. I mean, he's a hero that if you get up that ultimate, he doesn't care about Doom. He's all physical damage. It's exactly everything you need against Doom. But Pylai Dai is going to be providing a helping hand for Misery, creating some space and some distractions in this bottom lane. As Vici Gaming are centered up as four to go for the Bounty Rune. Ice. Perhaps looking for a steal as he's going to be the offlane Slardar looking at the top lane.
He definitely can't contest this here. He could easily just get shackled and killed. So Puppy scouts it out. Nobody is there. And that will be the rune for Weehan. See what build he goes. He does have a Null Talisman. What do you think? Which build do you think is going to be better? Do you think he's going to go Tornado EMP or just a straight typical Exhort stuff?
I'm looking at this lineup. I know oftentimes like the Chinese scene like to be able to run the Quasuix Invoker when you're dealing with an Undying or Slardar. I think some of the strength heroes that have low mana pools, I think you could really abuse that. And I look at the Slardar and perhaps it's going to interrupt to the Spirit Breaker and good against Queen of Pain. But I'm concerned about the Lycan and whether or not they'll actually have enough damage to be able to deal with him. And Secret do have some potential setup stuns for early Sun Strikes, most notably being the Shadow Shaman. But we'll have to see. Bounty Hunter, of course, he's going to be rotating around and he's going to make his first entrance into the middle lane here shortly, but there is a counter ward waiting for his show. Pylai Dai will get a little bit of damage out. The charge is going to come out, immediately throws out the counter ward and takes away the opposing counter ward. He is still going to be charged up, and he broke his invis too. He's going to take some damage here. They pop the dust, but they can't pursue into the tower. Pylai Dai, one step ahead without an Orb of Venom or boots on either one of these heroes.
So that was really efficient for Pylai Dai. He killed 100 gold of a sentry ward, and he killed 90 gold worth of a dust. And he's pressuring Super
with
here.
With the cold snap, they're going to be able to try and go for the kill. They need a little bit more. Pylai Dai, another hit, but he starts healing salves up. And Lycan will be okay.
Very, very close there. Salve's going to help a lot. 500 gold on him now. What do you do with mid Lycan? Is it consistent that you go for bottle here? I guess against a ranger, he will be taking health points harass, but he can leverage it for the wolves, I guess? Or
I feel it's a bit more likely that he just maybe buys some more regen and gets boots, but we'll see. The Bounty Hunter, especially the early slow of Janata and Orb of Venom, are going to cause so many issues. I'm not sure.
Once the wolves are up, though, he can definitely use them to help zone the Invoker. Invoker will have some natural regen because of Quas, but depending on which build he goes, he may have more or less of that.
Yeah, controlling runes as well can be very helpful from the wolves. And looks like he's about to pick up his bottle with this last hit if he goes that route. Meanwhile, the top lane, how's that going for the Slardar here? Ice. With just the Stout Shield and Mango left middle lane, they actually are going to go in. Super is going to be dove quite heavily here. They're trying to go on pie with the Wolves. They will have the charge out from Venrir. Maybe he can get the return kill. Pops the dust, needs another hit. The Wolves are going to provide a little bit more, but it's not enough. Venrir gets body blocked up, and now Misery hoping to be able to get another one, but he's too low. And Weehan won't be able to make the dive, but they got first blood on the Lycan.
See, I like how Secret plays this Doom. I feel like a lot of teams aren't doing this enough. They need to roam occasionally because the hero is giving himself 23 HP regen per second. Yeah, he's got no base armor here, but with just a boots and this extra movement speed from Scorched Earth, you can just run people down. It's very simple to do this gank. You don't really need a lot of creep variety. You can just have Scorched Earth a couple levels and you can gank a lane.
Easy tower dimes, VG Gaming. are suffering a little bit. FY, he did throw down a counter ward, but he hasn't actually seen that obs ward yet.
Yeah, it's possible he didn't spot it. Surely he would have dewarded if he saw it, unless he's looking for some timing like stack, but he's not. I think he just thinks he didn't get it.
Yeah, didn't walk all the way over to the left, doesn't see that obs ward, so the camp is going to continue to be blocked out. Pileidai has been very efficient, as you said. He managed to force a lot there from his first little setup in the middle lane, and then obviously
helping the courier's going to spot it. Okay, he's going to see it now.
Is this some
Are
sort
you serious?
Of
What's,
weird bait
is this
scenario?
Is this a bug? Like, what is going on? How did he not see that? Does the courier give, like, very, very small vision or something?
Yeah, maybe FY didn't see it. I think it's just perhaps up just above the tree area.
Oh, man, he's going to be kicking himself when he watches the replay.
Yeah. It's just high enough against that one white tree that you can't quite see it. You have to move over farther to the left. Pileidai sees Fenrir and his rotations around.
It's going to cost him so much that he hasn't spotted this, honestly. He does have another sentry ward. He's going to spot it. Oh, go south.
Go
just
around.
Get it.
FY, go around.
Okay.
The timing finally sees it.
Jeez.
I mean, I've never heard a crowd cheer so loud for a ward being countered, but FY finally gets it 4.5 minutes in, but the ward was still efficient enough.
His sentry is pretty high in the bottom. There's a chance it might block as well, but I have a feeling he knows the limits, but you never know. So the harass now coming on Weehaw. He's starting to spawn his wolves a lot. This is the point where they get pretty annoying, is level 3. I think they go invis.
Cold snap, EMP, burning. Or rather, super, sorry, he's gonna lose his mana. The charge out to bottom lane, they do see Pileidai. Spiritbreaker has some more dust. Pi, he's not getting out of this one.
I think he's pretty happy with this. He's had a pretty good early game. Level 3 on him, 5 minutes, not bad. Caused a lot of congestion in the jungle. Looks like that camp did not spawn, by the way. I don't know if it got body blocked by Spiritbreaker charging through or something, but nothing there for a bit. Luckily, this ward's almost dead. 13 seconds. Super's back mid. Misery's here as well, actually trying to set up a gank. It's waiting for him to come back.
The charge is now going to come out, but without level 6, there's just no way. And no mana, by the way, on Super either, because that EMP can't do anything in this middle lane.
That's one of the really nice things about having a strength hero mid, is that there's way less mana for him to drain. So if he has no mana and he can just bottle up whatever he's losing, then it's a matchup that Weehaw can't abuse as much. Less damage, less mana, all that good stuff. New sentry ward placed down. Pileidai is going to be spotted.
Maybe they can get the gank on him with FY here as well. They're trying to stack up the camps a little bit. Lycan, he can do full-time jungle here pretty soon. Ice is going to be caught while trying to go for the rune, but does get a nice two-man crush to stop both Misery and Pileidai.
Pileidai does get the regen. Misery's level 6 is coming a little slow. He does have a TP scroll. Use Devour. I would have liked to instead maybe see him TP the bot lane, but he does find an Alpha Wolf, which is arguably the best creep that you can have on Doombringer. But some wasted experience here for Secret. I think they're okay with this, though. Envy's getting farm. He's got 38 CS here. He's not really being pressured. Ice is fairly zoned. I think Secret's in a good place here, and they're aiming to do well in the mid game too.
He's got a spot out super, farming up these camps. They're giving FY the experience in this middle lane to try and get his level 6 a bit faster. Pileidai goes into the trees before reactivating his invis to make sure he isn't spotted out by anybody. But Fenrir is just waiting for the bounty hunter maybe to show himself. Oh, the courier, that's going to be the opening.
Oh,
he gets
the
kill, and he gets out to Fenrir. He couldn't get the charge in time, and Pileidai scoots away to safety.
Ring of Basilius bottle and another set of tangos there for Super. That's such a huge snipe. Pileidai consistently playing one of the best bounty hunters in the world.
He is such a disruptive support, causing Vici Gaming so many problems in the first 5 minutes of this game. And he's now going to try and take a look at this top lane where Slardar is level 5 now. He's been doing all right for himself, zoned out a bit by, of course, Shadow Shaman and Ember Spirit do have a good amount of kill potential if they're able to ever get that first disable onto the Slardar.
Well, they're looking to do it. There isn't a sleight of fist on Ember Spirit, but he does have his ultimate to close the gap. So, and especially with Pylodon on the opposite side, they can slow him extra if he gets a little bit too far away. No boulder toss
ice
anymore.
Ice gets close. Pylodon leads with the Janata, gets the chains as well, and Ice, a two-man crush will not stop his death. His puppy will claim the kill. Eternal Envy is low, though. FY is going to come in. They do manage to get the charge on the Pylodon. They'll take that for sure, but at the same time, Burning has been caught. He's trying to get the blink away. The last second will be able to get out. Misery is quite low underneath that tier one tower, but won't be going down yet. Burning is now going to be attacked by Weehawk. Gumpton throws out the EMP. Tornado clips Burning, and it's enough. Weehawk gets the kill. Fenrir blocked up by creeps as well. Weehawk gets some more damage on him before he leads out Vici Gaming. They lose their Slardar. They thought they were going to be able to get some sort of turnaround, but the heroes get split. They get controlled up too much, and they end up feeding away a kill on Burning on top of everything else.
So Seeker keeps getting advantage. The core that they have, the Lycan, is still being slowed down. He's got 43 CS, which is pretty good, but again, that late D ward leads to 8 minutes, 45 seconds. Visage is still level 4. That is not where FY wants to be. He wants to be accelerating on farm. Misery's getting dived, though, by Super. The TP comes.
Tornado EMP is going to land on Super, and it might be enough damage. It is. Doom gets that kill. Another turnaround from Secret. Vici Gaming just can't seem to get a hold on this early game.
They're doing so well, man. Great disables all over the place. They're backing each other up.
Ice starts moving forward, catching Puppy without any mana. There's going to be a TP in from Burning, and Puppy, he's surely to go down here as Burning gets the last nuke in. Eternal Envy, does he really have a response? He's going to try and get close enough for the chains, but I don't think he can fight these two heroes together.
This is that dangerous moment where Slaughter is just going to put Eternal Envy in negative armor, and any rotation of a gank plus a stun means a dead Ember Spirit. And it could be Burning. He has shifted back towards mid lane area, but there's not really that much to farm here. It's going to penalize FY because it'll delay FY6. So I feel like I would have preferred him just to stay top, maybe try to get this Envy kill. It's definitely difficult, though. I doubt he'll let himself get crushed.
Pylodon, careful where you tread, my friend. He's hanging around this middle lane. There is some counter vision. As soon as Misery shows himself, Burning does blink away. And the bounty rune will be secured for Eternal Envy, refilling that bottle. Meanwhile, Weeha has all the space in the world. He's got Phase Boots Urn and is halfway through his Orchid already. Vici Gamer going to have to group up really early on if this Orchid completes by about 15 minutes.
And we're going to do some harass on Ice on the top lane. Fenrir's here too, only level 3 though. Not a massive amount of damage. He's got to stay away from the crush, but still within the damage aura.
The charge is
going
to come in. He will be able to get stunned up. Ice trying to stay ahead of Eternal Levy. It's going to be he who dies. He bounced out. Okay. He had a remnant still in the river and gets away. Cheeky bugger. Now they're going to be able to have the Doom on a Burning inside of the enemy jungle. Burning's going down. Misery's just going to chase him all the way. No chance for a deny.
Man, they have the best co-op counters this game.
Do you have enough damage, though, to be able to solo up Misery? He's going to bring him low with the familiars. Of course, the lack of armor on Misery. He's going to come in with Super as well. The physical damage is enough. They get a return kill. But Secret are still going to be happy with the exchange. And now they're going to go for more. Start looking at FY. We'll be able to take him out nice and quick with Pylodon. Super, his ultimate lasts long enough for him to get out.
Have to use the sentry to kill the wolves here, otherwise Puppy could be chased down, but Secret's going to be really happy with that one. Even with Doom dying, he's on cooldown with his ultimate. His death in an offlane scenario, he's going to be really happy. They have such good co-op counters as well. Ember Spirit, Searing Chains obviously being amazing. They've got Doom as well. They can do EMP Tornado situations, drain his mana, don't let him blink that way.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the Orchid, once it's up on the Invoker, that's going to be yet another huge counter to the Queen of Pain. And we're looking again at the co-op. Burning does this time and time again. It's going to be going for the Orchid build. That means the BKB is going to be severely delayed unless some Vici Gaming start finding some miracle good team fights.
But his Orchid is delayed to the point where Invoker is going to have a huge advantage with it. Invoker's Orchid with the Quaswex build, it's normally not amazing because of the fact that the enemy team usually just starts grouping up and they say, well, yeah, Invoker can solo kill us, but we'll just not let him solo kill us, and then he's not going to get any farm, and then he's super going to fade off by the time we get BKBs. But Weeha has this so early, and his team has so much advantage that I feel like he's actually going to get value out of it.
Smoke rotation coming out from Vici, Burning, and Ice joining forces. Magic, physical, and pure damage. They've got it all if they could just find the right hero to pick off. They're going to look towards the middle lane, try and wrap around there. They have a charge out onto Weeha to lead things off. Misery sitting on the side, and he may be able to provide enough disruption. Ice, Ice, Ice leads in. Heads to Amplify, but a beautiful tornado is going to stop some of this. Now the Doom goes out on Ice, Ice, Ice. Our turnaround, Eternal Envy's here. Fenrir completes his charge, still trying to go on to Weehawk. Sonic Wave claps him in the end, gets the turnaround kill. Fenrir commits to Eternal Envy, who managed to pop his Rend in order to get the kill. Super surrounded now. He's going to be going
all
down
as well.
Eternal Envy gets burning. Oh no, Secrets. They just destroyed VG Gaming in this fight. They're going to get the familiars on top of everything else.
Envy's on cooldown for his ult. He definitely would have gone in for that one. They get both familiars. That's 200 gold and 30 seconds left until Visage gets his ult back up. They got so much value there. Boots of Travel already up on Envy. 5 assists, no kills or anything like that, but he's going to be absolutely happy giving that gold to his team.
FY, daring Eternal Envy sitting on top of that remnant because he does have allies coming in. Pylite die.
He's got track.
They've got dust on Ice, Ice, Ice as well, but Pylite die is hiding.
Oh, he goes in.
They're going to go back for FY. The TP's come in, but FY's already dead. Super, I'm not sure if he wants to complete this one. He doesn't have the backup of the rest of his team yet.
And Bounty Hunter, a hero that spent all of his time roaming, is now up to 1,000 gold past his Arcane Boots. The items are coming for Secret, and their carry potential is looking good as well.
And they've still got Serpent Wards if they want to be able to take more objectives. They also have Dire Sight. Roshan is another thing that Secret can take rather easily thanks to the Shadow Shaman Serpent Wards.
Yeah, that's a huge advantage. One of the reasons that Shadow Shaman has been picked, because you drop your ultimate and you take a tactical advantage. Will they drop it for the Rosh, though? They will.
Yeah, they probably deem it just a bit too dangerous to stick inside the Roshan pit for too long and let VG Gaming perhaps find an opening.
Spindallion's on the way. There's actually a lot of items on the way. Orchid's finished on Invoker, 14 minutes. Oh my gosh.
Oh, got denied by the Lycan Wolf.
Super! That could have just been such a big play. Denying that Aegis away from Team Secret may prevent the next team fight just immediately going Team Secret's way. I couldn't see how VG Gaming would be able to fight around two lives on Weehaw, but Super may have just found the potential play.
Oh,
Ice is going to be targeted here by the Doom. Tornado comes down, managed to dodge it, but it looks like the sprint is going to be enough combined with the Doom to take him out. But Weehaw's the turnaround kill. It looks like he's dropping low.
They
Super catches him in the end. One for one trade off so far. Fenrir couldn't get the bash in time.
That
Team
was...
Secret get away with the rest of the heroes.
That was great, man. Was he the one that was going to carry the Aegis? If so, that would have been him alive.
Yeah.
Secret could have just traded and turned around and fought. They obviously killed Ice, Ice, Ice there, but trading it for their super farmed Invoker, I'm not sure that's what they wanted. Vici's going to be really happy with us. Nice little turn of events. There's a big gold advantage going towards Secret, but Vici is still very strong in some organized bursts. Lots of chain stun. Secret doesn't have the typical defensive support like Winter Wyvern, Dazzle. Positioning is actually everything in this game.
And VG Gaming also has some heroes that are insanely good at taking objectives in short periods of time. If they actually do win a fight, you're going to see towers dropping like flies.
Yeah, that's classic Lycan. He goes somewhere, sends his wolves, pushes lanes, might show up there, forces you to back up and cover yourselves. Luckily for Secret, though, they do have Ember Spirit, one of the best anti-split pushers. Drop a remnant, TP back to base, defend, and then return to your team.
Yeah, especially with the Boots of Travel build that he already has and is well on his way to a Battle Fury. Has the Perseverance, another 500 gold. Secret are rotating around. Pylite Dai is leading the way with the Smoke Ink. Weehaw right behind him. They're going to run into Super here. He doesn't have his ultimate. They're going to lead a little chicken. Serpent Ward's getting laid out. Super is going to be food for fodder. They try and go on Puppy at the same time. They get the stun onto Misery. Burning comes in. They don't have the Sonic Wave. Now he does. Has enough mana. Takes out Misery. And Secret will start retreating. They have Eternal Envy here, and they've got the vision on VG Gaming. Do they really want to take this? They'll start going on to FY. Fenrir's ready to go with the charge almost, but they can't fight this one. So much track. Weehaw even going for more now, as Fenrir feels the damage of the cold snap on him.
They have so much burst on both sides of the team there.
Ice. Not going to try and stop him. Just get some amplified damage out. But Bounty Hunter returns with some vision of his own. Throws a track onto the Slardar.
That's not awful for Vici Gaming as well. They forced Puppy to drop his wards. Maybe not forced, but the engagement happened not next to the tower. If those wards were down next to the tower, Secret would have gotten that tower down to 20% at least there before retreating. So that was a decent way for them to play things. Force Puppy to not drop wards by tower. Take fights where you get some kills and trade some in return, and allow your split push and maybe your late game potential to come in.
VG Gaming, things are going to get really, really scary. if they try and go for this top tower defense. I doubt they will. Tier 1 tower is already down. But there was some nice vision laid out by Pileidai behind the tower. And actually allows him to get a track now on the super. Secret are not going to stop just yet. They're going to go for the tier 2.
I don't blame them.
VG Gaming, they've smoked up. Eternal Envy does pop the smoke on FY. Super pops his ultimate and Secret. Now gonna retreat out, the charge is coming in, Vici Gaming still wanna fight this one, Tornado EMP provides some interception, quick disable on Ice, he's not gonna get out the stun as well, Vici Gaming are now have to run the other way, the dog just gets immediately doomed up, Super's gonna try and stay ahead of Misery, and looks like he will be able to get out, but the rest of Vici Gaming are all just free cleanups now for Team Secret.
Bernie will get the deny on Super, but that just wasn't a fight that Vici Gaming was going to win as soon as they backed off. Like, I don't know why Super uses ultimate at all. It only lasts for 18 seconds. It's a limited window. So as soon as he used it, Vici Gaming said, well, we have to go now. And then you're chasing five heroes. They've got a drum of endurance, so they're running really fast. And you know that he's going to be able to tornado the Spirit Breaker, completely preventing his charge. You can't have that kind of initiation against the heroes that Secret has.
Yeah, the Tornado EMP was so disrupted there, but also the quick reactions of both the Shadow Shaman as well as Weehaw. They both hexed up and orchided the Slardar to make sure he couldn't get that follow-up initiation.
And that's because of the ward they placed. They saw him coming.
Mm-hmm. Burning is going to be caught out. The Orchid controls him long enough for Eternal Levy to help get the kill. Fenrir now comes in, actually pops up a tornado, stops a nether strike. He's still going to complete. No, he's not. Trying to go on Eternal Levy, but he's got to rend the jump away. And Fenrir.
Are they going to go for this?
It looks like if they get the chains, Fenrir is still plenty tanky, ice, chasing away these heroes.
No spells on Invoker right now, otherwise they maybe could have followed up there, but this two-man ganking combo, Ember Spirit and Invoker, they're so hard to kill. Both very evasive, very fast movers, lots of disable options, and the Battle Fury is up in 19 minutes here on Eternal Envy. 140 CS, 50 more than anyone else in this game.
And they have another 3.5 minutes until Roshan 2. The Bounty Hunter picking up the mech. We'll have Guardian Greaves probably pretty soon as well. That'll help deal with the amplified damage on himself as well as keep Secret above the kill threshold against all this burst damage of VG Gaming. Oh, Pylite die. He just ran in. That's perfect though. He interrupts the smoke. He's gonna die here. But Team Secret, I think, are going to be happy with that exchange, stopping the four-man smoke rotation of VG Gaming.
Yeah, I agree. That's absolutely worth it, because the only way that Secret loses a fight, in my opinion, is if they get caught unawares. Smoking is the best way to do that. Much better to trade your Bounty Hunter for this. It doesn't matter if he loses gold. He just has to be in the vicinity of somebody else dying. He's going to get it right back.
The Battle Fury from Eternal Envy. We'll easily push back this wave from VG Gaming. Unless VG Gaming managed to find some sort of initiation, I'm not sure how they're going to be able to actually take a fight here. It doesn't seem like Ice sees any opening, so VG Gaming will start backing up. An invis rune for Fenrir, maybe that can change things around.
I feel like Fenrir has to not charge from the front, because there is going to be a tornado flying through the mix of things.
Right.
And they have so many good ways to just stop his charge. Same thing.
If they can get the stun. No, Eternal Envy. Again, the vision advantage. Pylai dying. This ward is twice now. Set him up either to win the fight or allow Eternal Envy to dodge the incoming gank.
And they cut the wave bottom a little bit. They're getting ready to set up wards, and this is going to mean that VG Gaming's late. The charge is actually coming from Fenrir, but he's got to stop. The timing isn't right. He has to go in with his team. And like I said before, I think he has to come from a weird angle because he's going to get disabled.
Yeah.
He's too underfarmed at this point, and their heroes counter him too much. If you prevent the charge from landing, then Spirit Breaker is just a bad hero.
Just like last game, we're looking at almost a 15,000 gold lead by 20 minutes for Team Secret. And it's just going to keep climbing as they take more of these objectives. Roshan's going to be targeted as well. They have the charge onto Misery. They actually see him pretty alone here. Leading with the Orchid. Will be able to get the stun. This should be a free pickoff.
It's a good pick for VG Gaming. 539 gold going to Ice. He gets his first kill of the game. And some much needed levels on Fenrir as well.
Now the jump in. They're going to catch Puppy as well. That was 1,200 gold in total for just a pickoff on Misery. And then you combine it now with Puppy going down and a tier 1 tower falling. And VG Gaming gets some much needed gold to continue their item progression.
A little bit of mistake in Secret's plans, but it's not the end of the world here. Really good observer wards placed by VG Gaming as well. There's been a lot of movement in the middle of the map, so it's good to track where that is. But with that said, the Ags is up on Invoker, and it's on the way. Now, it's got buffed recently. There's a little bit more value that you get out of each point that you have. You get an extra level of Quaswex or Exhort, so you're going to see the best damn EMP possible. I don't even know how much mana it's going to drain. 625.
Mana? Are you kidding me? That's half of Burning's pool.
That's so big. If he actually drains him, he's not going to be able to do a full combo. It's that simple. Using Orchid alone is 100. This EMP could be so big. Drain all of Lycan's mana. Drain all of Spearbreaker's mana. Slardar, all of his mana. If they get a good EMP, it's fight's completely over. Completely stopped. They do find the Observer Ward, though. They're thinking about smoking, perhaps. There is one on Puppy, yes. Good thing they put that sentry down. But either way, I think it's pretty clear. Vici Game is going to say they're four heroes. Yeah, look, Ice, perfect positioning. Breaks the smoke on Weeha. And no smoke gank just yet for Secret.
That'll help keep his four staff coming to him. He's only 800 gold away from that one. FY, meanwhile, he's pushing out the bottom lane. He could complete a Solar Crest if he wanted to. But perhaps he's going to think about instead going for the Aghanim Scepter. Yeah. Gets the intel as well as the strength item. And Vici Gaming is going to be their best opportunity. A five-man smoke. They're going to be running into Team Secret here, making the initiation. They're going to go into Puppy first, trying to pop him. But the rest of the team is a little bit slow in following that up. Weeha's going to be able to provide some disruption. Throws out the Deafening Blast. Fenrir immediately gets controlled up. He's going to be taken out, it looks like, his Puppy. He'll get the turnaround kill as FY claims at least one here, but it's one for two. Looks like it's about to be three as Burning gets doomed up. And Eternal Left, he should have no problem chasing that one down with his Blink Dagger. Surrounding Super as well. He knows he's gone. Vici Gaming, they just seem broken after that second game from Team Secret. Getting a fifth kill, that's a wipe. Vici Gaming at 25 minutes in, they seem utterly outplayed and outdrafted by Team Secret in this game three.
Now that Secret has the gold advantage, when the tracks come out, how can they get away from them? It doesn't matter that your Lycan runs max.
Team Secret. They've broken Vici Gaming. There's no other way to describe that one. Two 25-minute victories in a row for Team Secret after a tough game one. Showing championship style here, recovering from a tough loss like that.
And they guarantee themselves top three in this event. They're going to move on to play Evil Genius in the upper